Thank you. James Jefferson. Eugene Pack, number 22. Jake Gillen, number 53. Third captains for York. Thank you. Cunningham and Bruce Lee.
So
number 37. Thank you. pitches to Bailey. Jeremy Stevens on the recovery. No strikes are called.
Okay.
receive. Wonderful Jackson covering the next day. picks it to Curry. Yes, sir. Thank you. address of the song. High School, runners up in Glasgow game. The superintendent of Edgefield County, board member Seth Crouch, and the principal of South Thurman High School, Joel Musgrave. Representing York High School, the superintendent of York School District Number 1, Dr. Ellison Smith, board chairman Dr. Billy Sanderberg, and the principal Bob Harrison. On behalf of the teams, please take their positions on the field.
A sweep.
Steve Bellin, Bill McCown, Academy, assisting in the presentation and to make presentations. It's me, Mr. Pete Aherne, the executive director of the South Carolina High School League.
Says our teams are doing pretty good from our
state teams, 2 out of 3. Yeah,
not
that's
bad.
That's not too bad. Last year, I'm trying to remember if we did quite, I can't remember. Let's just talk about this year, right? Last year is history. Today, we can talk about a couple of upstate winners, and we can start off with the game in Columbia between York and Strom Thurmond. Bill Pate's Cougars went down there and they played themselves a pretty good football game, and they bring home a title to the upstate, as Lonnie McCullough explains.
It's hard to believe York even made it to the 3A title game in Williams-Brice Stadium. That is, if you think back to September when they were 1-3. But fortunes changed, and the Cougars were in Columbia.
Defense has been the key to a lot of York's success so far this season. And tonight, at least early, it proved successful once again.
Robert Berkins did the honors early in the second quarter, finding himself in the right place at the right time. His interception set up York's first and only touchdown. Corey Patton was the man this time around the right side. His score put the Cougars on top 7-0, ending a playoff shutout for Strom Thurmond. In the second half, Steve Hollis, Thurmond's powerful running back, gobbled up yardage at an alarming rate, pushing his Rebels ever closer to the York goal line. This would be Thurmond's best opportunity to score, but the York defense held and kept the Rebels out of the end zone. Strong defense kept the Cougars out of the end zone as well. In fact, they wouldn't come any closer than 38 yards. And that's when sophomore Peter Carroll, who had missed a field goal earlier, nailed this one to give York a 10-0 lead late in the fourth quarter.
Couldn't even feel my foot when I was going out there, and Mark just said, Mark was talking to me and tell me how he was going to hold good this time. Everything went well.
10-0 was the final. York, the state 3A champions.
This bunch is the biggest bunch of overachievers I've ever seen. I tell you, they're the biggest bunch of overachievers I've ever seen anywhere. I've been around football a long time, but I'll take this bunch.
We're very fortunate to win, but I tell you what, we love it. Everybody in York loves it. Just look up in that crowd. Oh, they love it.
It's been 23 years since a York team made it to the finals. Tonight, they made it worthwhile. I'm Lonnie McCullough, TV7 Eyewitness Sports, Columbia.
It's just great seeing how much fun they have. Good news for Louis.